Alrighty, guys. We're gonna figure this foregrip out. It's definitely challenging figuring out what I'm going to do here. Thank you. Hey, Biyoshi. What's up, dude? Been a while since I caught a TR stream, TSR stream. How long? A week or so. Oh, that's not bad. I was assuming you were meaning like months or something. Yeah, that's a good point, considering how often streams happen. Yeah, well, me, Josh, and Damien, we've been. It's almost like there's a stream every day. Tell you what, this foregrip is probably the most challenging part of this weapon. Just figuring out what to do here. Because the original one is just weird looking. I do not like the original one at all. So you try and stay as true as you can to the original, or do you go a little more freestyle with the updated version? I copy all the basic shapes, and then I go from there. Like I try and maintain the key shapes. So this is the original model right here. So this is what the foregrip was like, which is weird. So, obviously trying something different. I think if anything that's more different than the original, it's the foregrip. That just looks painful to hold. Yeah, I guess so. Probably not for a monkey, though. don't know. It just looks weird. I'm gonna try to work elsewhere. I'll come back. This is better than the original design. Or what I had before, at least. I'll definitely return to that. I have to come back and just do something else later. Not a huge fan of this. Take that out. Yeah, I don't know, Biyoshi. I'm picky. I think if anything, I want to have this device probably connecting to the bottom and the top thing here. Which maybe, I hope that's not pushing it, but this is all I have. This is all I have to go off right there, so. Yeah, that's another good point. That is, when I looked at the original and Feature Perfect, I found out that all this stuff, all these pieces, like this whole like inner section, is like the slider, if you will, like it moves back when it fires. I definitely don't want to have that be a thing. Let's see, I might come up with something different. It was definitely game magic. Yeah, so that's probably what you could say I'm working on now. It's making that feasible as to why it can project a shield. That is a really good point. Yeah, I definitely gotta beef up the end here to make that seem feasible. If we weren't using CryEngine and we can do Unreal, I would definitely like rig this gun in a way that lets like have like some more moving components. But until we really figure out the inner workings of CryEngine, I don't think that's gonna be possible for now. Overanalysis man of video game nonsense. Yes. That almost sounds like a YouTube channel. General lack of cohesion between nitpicks. That's good. I like that one. Gonna be famous overnight. I don't know about that, but. Wondering how I want to connect this. I just freehand it. Yeah, that's kind of what I'm going for, Biyoshi. Yeah, it kind of looks ridiculous reaching over like that. I don't want to do that. So what are your plans for modeling future weapons, or at least ones I'm looking forward to? There's so many. I mean, that's a hard one. As far as ones I'm looking forward to, because there are a lot. It'd be nice to get the TS2 sci-fi auto rifle done, or plasma auto rifle. That one I'm kind of looking forward to. I mean, just the design of it was pretty intriguing to me when I was younger. I played the game. I will say, to better answer your question, for the month of February, I definitely want to get done one of the plasma auto rifles from the second or third game. It's very likely that we're going to be doing another developer update by the end of next month, so I kind of want to save a couple for like a surprise for that video. So I kind of don't want to talk about the two guns that I have planned, at least until then. Because this rifle will be done by the end of the month, easily. Or sniper rifle. I'm glad you like the Soviet rifle. That one is pretty much already modeled. And I think that the texturing is almost done too. I know I've already done animations for it. May actually get rid of these. Yeah, the Soviet rifle has kind of been or the S-47 or whatever, it's been our test bed weapon for getting things to work in CryEngine. So we've been working a lot with that weapon. It was the actual rig. The rig that we used was rigged by someone else. It's no longer on the team, and so I've been having to try and figure out how they rigged it, and so why it works in CryEngine and why my pistol model doesn't work in CryEngine. his scope is like touching the... Oh my gosh, it's so close to touching the this piece here. Jeez. I want to raise this just a tiny bit. Tiny smidgen. There we go. It's a little bit. Actually, it's really just these extrusions that need to be brought back in. And do that at some point. Yeah, I could go more fantastical here, right? Last thing I want to do is make this look like robotic, but let's just figure out something. Just thinking, if the shield that gets projected is like a circle, I mean, theoretically the laser charge coming out will not, I mean, like the shield would not be covering up the part where the barrel is, so that could help influence the design a little bit. Yeah, that's a good point. I could throw it on the right side. But then that would really mess with my head. Like, I like things to be, like, you know, symmetrical. And if the shield is a complete, like, circle, I think it makes sense to have, like, you know, devices on both sides for that kind of thing. Yeah, bullets could phase through the shield. Yeah, and honestly, I it's so far out. I don't honestly don't know when we're gonna have this gun in the game. I'm just trying to get, you know, to get ahead on models as far ahead as I can. So I think it's better if we have guns that need to be textured versus having a texture artist that doesn't have anything to texture. Because other than the texturing part, we can get these working and in-game. There's still a lot of work to be done. So, I mean, we can have guns that work in-game that we don't release for like 6 months because they don't get textured. That kind of sounds ridiculous, but it's the truth. Yeah, that's a point. I mean, we're farther behind on gun models than you would think for this project being in development on and off for 5 years. We're really far behind. I don't think that's too, this isn't too invasive of the original design, but I think I might just try and pull this back more. Yeah, any progress is a step forward. Yeah, it is. You're right. I might leave it at that for now. I don't know. I feel like this should be exaggerated out. I mean, I'm thinking about first person view, and I don't want this blocking that much. You know, when you're trying to look around and whatnot. Yeah, I don't know about that. I don't know. I kind of want to have this wire that runs along all the way down, but I don't want to Because, like, this is nice and clean right here, and I don't want to kind of mess that up. I think I'll just leave that alone then. But we do need to duplicate this and move it. I think that's too terrible looking. Yeah, Ghost, there is still much more to do. I thought we was done last stream. No. No, not at all. The foregrip needed work, and that, this is what I did earlier before you got here. That's, not entirely happy with it. I mean, I think this shape is fine, but the actual integration and the way this flows to up here, I'm not sold on that yet. And the barrel, I think I kind of want to add stuff in here, but I don't think it needs it, especially now that we have all this in here. Probably take this little stub thing out now. It was a good idea at first, but couldn't really run with that at all. Do you have a template, or are you making those from scratch? I have a template. We have the original models. Boom. This is the original one. And so the starting point, if you look at my streams in the playlist, you can go back and watch the one where I basically copied every shape. And so then I copy the shapes, and then I go from there. Is there going to be laser dots to at least give away the sniper position as a camper deterrent? That's a design thing that I'm not... that's not kind of like my call, really. And that's so far out, I don't think I have an answer for that, to be honest. Time Splitters is such a fast-paced game, too. I don't like the idea of just doing what like Halo and like Destiny are doing and just having this glare, you know? Yeah, it's a sniper. Took this part off. I gotta take that one off too. Yeah, I mean, really, that would only be an issue in, like, big maps. I mean, Time Splitters had what? Like, Siberia from Feature Perfect? That was a big map. I mean, Training Ground, you can camp in the bases, but they're going to know where you are. There was never really, like, a Blood Gulch of Time Splitters where you could just be out in a big open field. I mean, maybe Planet X from Time Splitters 1, now that I think about it more, but... No, we've had some internal talks about possibly doing Planet X as one of our next maps here soon, but because I do want a sci-fi map. I've been telling the team, like, this is Time Splitters, and we're working on, you know, settings that are modern. And when I think about it more, it's like, don't you want to have more, you know, more of, like, variety? Because it is Time Splitters. Like, that, like, if the people haven't played the originals, how are you going to, you know, like, generate that appeal? That appeal is going to come from having maps that are, you know, different. is we have compound, and then they're working on, or we have a somewhat working version of hotel, and those are somewhat similar. I mean, they're not similar, but when you look at what Time Splitters has to offer, they are pretty close. Work on this shape for a little bit. Yeah, that tower where you could just get out of, get the buggy and then like park it and get out. I did that at one point. I can't say I discovered it by myself, but I remember hearing about that and I tried it and I did it. I accidentally select that. Oh, I didn't get this bottom edge. What am I doing? Top edge. Wall that had no collision. Oh. I should probably spend some time here in this grip. It's close, or it's getting there, but wonder if it'll let me bevel all this at once. Maya's picky. Sometimes she doesn't want to work. Hey, it works. I think that's a nice bevel. That looks beautiful. Except these guys here. I think I need to run another edge loop through here. I don't want these triangles. Oh, wait. Okay. You can hate on Destiny all you want, but the music is just gorgeous. He needs it to look edgy. Yep. You got me. When I visited Bungie Studios recently, last September, I got to speak with a man named Jay Weiland. He's the lead, pretty much one of the lead sound designers, and he told me the amount of like minutes that they had recorded, or like the actual amount of like music that they had done. And he specifically told me not to repeat the number, but I can tell you this: it was astronomical. It was ridiculous. Like just way, like, astronomically higher than, like, 3 hours. Way higher. He told me, and I was like, what? Of course, they had, like, five composers, I think. There we go, that looks nice. Now we got a bevel's inside. We got a triangle here, so it might not work. Hey, it worked. Uh-oh, what is that? Oh, an inside face. I don't know how high poly the guys want it, but we'll do some more polys. I think that's fine. I don't think this inside area needs more polys, to be honest. But it's, where's the button? There it is. Temporal uplink OP, please nerf. Yeah, it's funny. I don't think anyone's modeled that or worked. I'll be honest. I don't even know if. Yeah, I probably need to do that. I'm sure they've probably talked about it, but I don't know. These guys here, I'm probably gonna bring these back. Have them connect it into like a module. And this shape too, this just doesn't. It's not working. That's where you can see the seams right here. That is interesting how that's looking. I don't know why. Lol. I think we need to bevel this area. Maybe these the inside's fine. Here, the one from 2 or Future Perfect. Well, we're not doing... We don't have any story mode stuff for Future Perfect in the works right now. So, no, that module where you can grab stuff. Or the... I guess it's also like a really terrible-looking radar, but... I don't know why I'd use that thing. Oh, yeah, they're not connected. Look at that. Just such a weird shape. I got a few more edges here going on. It's horrible. Yeah. Yeah, it is. It's not great. I do need to do something with this. Yeah, the lighting, it does. It's just hard to see. Janky. Alright. Do something like that and move those up. Oh my gosh, what is. Go. Oh! Woo! Okay. Yeah, we'll do something else. I'm gonna do a different approach with this guy. Oh, let's change the music. Let's do something else. What do we got? Oh, what's going on there? That is looking interesting. Huh. That looks pretty. I like that. We gotta do something about this stuff though. This looks a little janky. This curve here is not too great. I think this shape is fine. I think that's good enough. Actually, this bit right here. Oh, it's doing the same thing. Get back here. Yeah, that looks nice and clean for the most part. Oh, except he's got pulled inward. The symmetry thing is kind of iffy sometimes, but it's not worth messing with. X, but whatever. You can see that weird shape happening there. Are there any plans in place for arcade and challenge modes? Yes. Yes, there are. I think it's already been said, so I think I'm okay to say this, but on the initial release, we want some variety. So, like, Siberia, and then at least one arcade level, and then, like, challenge or two. I need to use some of these buttons too. These little knobs. This is way smaller than the original, but that's whatever. Keep those there for now. Should do something here with this guy. This piece here. Kiss my exhaust pipe. That's funny. That's good. I like it. Thank you. Yeah, that looks weird. I might just bevel the outsides for now. Figure out something on the insides later. Ah, I forgot the edge. Or did I? Maybe somewhere in here we could have the slider thing that flies back when it fires. I'll figure that out later. I'm probably only gonna go another 20 minutes, guys. I don't wanna go too late. Thinking what I want to do here. Nah, it's already past midnight my time. I'm on Eastern Coast. It's 12:10 here. I should bevel these edges here. That's not right. Might redo all this right here. I don't like this rounded edge. Looking forward to seeing you guys animate all these weapons. If by you guys you mean me, yes. I'm the only one doing animation right now. Modeling, animation, and like the rigging too, which isn't that intensive, but and that's why I'm not doing textures, because I'm not a good texture artist. I hate texturing with a passion. But yeah, when I joined, I noticed we didn't have any animators currently, so I was like, well, I've done this for Unreal Engine, I'm sure I can figure it out, and I'm at least for like actually rigging the guns to make them work in CryEngine. That's what's been difficult, because for Unreal Engine, I can do it. I know how to get the guns all rigged up so that you can animate them and that Unreal will accept them when you import the animations. But CryEngine's different. Yay. Oh no, these aren't level. Are you kidding me? Oh my gosh, you gotta be kidding me. Almost don't look like they're connected, but yeah, sure enough at the top. Yeah, I'll need to clean that up too. Where are we at right now? 18,000 polys. I think. Yeah, these old little bolts that I did are 210 faces each. I need to replace all of them, the smaller ones I redid. These little guys. Tried. Okay, so replaced all the little bolts. We're down about 3,000 polys. So yeah, that definitely saved us a little bit. The cylinders are what's killing us. Plus, I think it's also counting the original. And the original mesh that was 1,500. So it's not much, but. So yeah, if we select all this, yeah, it's under 14,000. This one's a bit higher than the other ones for sure. We're definitely getting there. I think one more session and I could get this baby all wrapped up. Probably another 3-4 hours, honestly. Probably Monday night. I think I'll stream Monday night. I just want to do something here though before I get off. Okay. Yeah, I'll probably do it around 8 or 9. Just kind of thinking what I want to do here. Give me Tuesday for you. Yeah, sorry about that. I know there's fans are in the US and the UK, and that can make things tough for people. But I save all the streams. You can watch them. I have a playlist. If you, for whatever reason, you want to watch them all, they're there. You can see them. Night shift, you know, just don't do anything. That's fair. So, I mean, I know we can get a texture here to make this pop more, but I feel like I need to do something more on the inside. I wonder why this pivot's off. I wonder what happened there. That one's fine. I doing? With Maya, you used to be able to buy it outright a long time ago for like $4,000. The reason I have it is because I'm a student, or at least I was. I just finished college. So with all Autodesk software, if you prove you're a student, you can get it for free, basically. If you're into torrenting, I mean, you know, that you can always get it. It's not my thing, really, but... Get her plate on this guy. If you're really wanting to, if you're serious and you want to get into this stuff, I mean, Blender is probably your best bet if you're not, if you don't want to torrent or like, you know. Yeah, virus risk, yeah. I don't blame you. If you can somehow prove that you're a student, then you can try that out. The Autodesk Education Community, that's what you want to look up. I think I'm gonna call it a night, though, guys. Good progress, but I gotta figure out. Let me see here. 15,000. This is the most highest poly gun that I've made so far right now. This beats the laser gun easily. I think it's definitely like ready, but. These knobs too. I need to fix that up. I'll have to simplify, figure some ways to get this lower. I want to get this. Ideally, this poly count should probably be at 13 or 14,000 max. But all this in here can probably get worked on. But I'm not gonna do a render either this time. I'm just gonna save it until I'm officially done with this. I'll show you guys, I know someone was talking about the S47 earlier. I'll show you guys what that's looking like. What do we got? What am I doing? Here we go. I think I showed this last time. See, the S47's only 5,000 faces. This is like a low poly version, but. Yeah, that's sniper rifle. We're gonna have to figure something out there, but. This is my working reload animation right now. I don't think it's that bad. But again, with TS2, we're going with a hands-off approach. No hands, so. My little Polly. Show you guys something more exciting. We got here? I guess the pickup's kind of cool. Probably a little fast, but I'm still deciding if I want to do an initial pickup and then a switch to. So like when you first pick up the gun, there's like a different animation, and then every time you switch back to it, it's just more simple. But as you can see, we have like 12 different animations for just one gun right now. So, yeah. A fire animation. It's only 4 frames, yay. I think the recoil is pretty okay. I don't know. Maybe it needs more. And the most exciting one, the idle animation. Yay. Oh, I didn't turn the camera around. It turns out, for whatever reason, turning the gun around 180 degrees was going to help it out. Or was going to help out the Crytek, or the CryEngine side of things for importing. So I had to go back in and edit all my animations. Oh my gosh, I forgot it's keyframed. Okay, my mistake. That's okay. We'll do it manual. All right, idle animation. Woo! I think it's very similar to TS2, to be honest. I mean, it's not much. I mean, I literally just probably spent like 15 minutes at max, at most. Just really want to see. I keep my graph editor on my left monitor. I don't like having all this stuff on the same screen. And this is literally all it is. Here are my keyframes. But keep that over there. What else? We'll do a little more field trip action. I like to do a field trip every stream. TS2. Maybe I'll do a stream sometime on some like rigging. I mean, I like to only stream when I'm doing something that's like intuitive, that I know what I'm doing. But much easier in Cinema 4D, huh? I haven't used it. What am I doing here? Modeling. Here's my laser gun. This bad boy is pretty much done. This is the first gun I did. I did this back in November. But, I'm liking how it looks. I even figured out, I thought about if you were to load like a new battery, and that it would be like somewhere in the back right here. I mean, it's probably not going to be like a thing, but that if you had to, like this thing would then shoot forward and you load the battery and then you pull it back. So, because these pipes are, this geometry here is pretty much just like the original. I actually don't have the original in here. I made most of this without the original model. It was very tedious and very tricky because I just was like referencing in-game stuff. But then I eventually, when I got the reference, I imported it, and this model was like 90% accurate. It was very close, thankfully. Yeah, that's our nice laser gun. I could probably fix up this grip here, foregrip, but other than that, this guy's pretty much done. And this one is at under 12,000 polys. Yeah, that's not bad. Cool. Oh, all right, guys. I'm just gonna load up. Sniper rifle. I don't know, this grip. I almost just want to get rid of it entirely. Cause your hand could go right here, and then the other arm could go right down there. I don't know. I might just have a basic shape that's flat, just come off right there. Anyway, I'll figure it out. If I could, I just want to get rid of this. Like, I like this big shape here, and I don't like how I have this other weird shape coming off of it. Oh well. But alright, that's it, guys. I'll catch you later. Thanks for tuning in. And I'll see you guys later.